Rajib is one of the co-founders of iRage, where he leads the prop trading business as its CEO, focusing on strategy development, risk management, and internal processes. So Rajib, what made you so passionate about quant trading that you chose it as a career?
I actually got recruited while I was still in campus by one of the biggest high-frequency trading and market-making firms in the world. So they invited me to have a look at their arbitrage trading desk and the market-making desk and then consider a career in this domain. So I saw that the traders there had tried to figure out pricing inefficiencies globally on the biggest exchanges in Europe and US, and they also basically were competing against thousands of traders globally and then to figure out pricing inefficiencies was. So this was a nice, interesting challenge that I saw. So therefore, I entered into this domain, and while after I entered into this domain, I realized that they were doing not just arbitrage, but then also in the game of market making, which involved actually finding the fair price of a financial instrument and then providing liquidity, which is providing both buy and sell quotes throughout the day on that instrument, and then do it in such a way that you do not get into things like inventory risk and then do not get gamed by people. So to be able to do that, you had to actually figure out what people are doing in the market, so how prices and are changing in the market. So those were challenges, puzzles that you had to solve on a daily basis, and which I loved so much. I stayed in this domain, and then it's been more than 10 years now, more than a decade in this domain already. So now, post that, we have ended up starting a firm of our own. So me and a few friends of mine. So yeah, so I've been in this domain for over a decade now.
What, according to you, is the most important technical skill required for this job?
Hi, that's actually a very nice question. I would break it down into two types of technical skills. One is the technical skills that you need to actually understand the financial instruments. What affects the pricing of that financial instrument. So I would call that the quant related technical skills. And then the second one, the second type of technical skills is actually your ability to leverage the power of technology. So those are the pure technology skills. Okay, so getting into the detail of both these aspects, the quant skills would be, for example, would depend on the asset class that you are trading in. So if you are trading, for example, equities, you would need to understand how to price equities on the basis of things like dividends, stock lending and borrowing rates, etc. If you are trading options, you would need to understand the different option pricing models, which model to use in which scenario, and so on. If you are using other asset classes like Forex, you would need to understand things like carry, interest rates, and so on and so forth. So that is one part of the technical skills that is required to excel in this domain. Other aspect of technical skills required to excel is actually the ability to work with technology. So what are these skills like? So for example, if you actually want to build a successful trading strategy, you first would need to validate a hypothesis, a trading hypothesis. And how do you do that? You actually run a lot of statistical tests against a huge amount of historical data, be certain that the trading hypothesis that you made is actually correct. So to be able to do that, you would actually need to be good with technology to be able to run your statistical tests against a huge amount of historical data.
What kind of mathematical knowledge is used by a quant trader on a regular basis? Can you give me an example?
So for example, time series analysis is something that everyone has to be good at to excel in this domain. And not just that, we also use a lot of machine learning to be able to classify data and then to do prediction and so on. So in addition to that, that's a very good question that you put. Can you please give an example? For example, a lot of statistical analysis that we do in our domain is very different from what people do in other domains. For example, you cannot use a causality test like Granger for working with high frequency data. That's because the data doesn't come in synchronous time gaps. So the kind of causality test that you would need to use in for high frequency data would differ greatly from the kind of statistical test that you would do in other domains. So in that way, what you need to do in our domain is sometimes greatly different, and then you have to add on top of things that you have already learned elsewhere.
How much of it did you learn on the job?
I actually entered this domain a long time back. At that point of time, we did not have a dedicated educational ventures training people to get into this job, to work in this domain. So while I learned everything on the job, these days there are great educational ventures like Quantitative, for example, training people to excel in this domain. So in our case, most of us learned everything in our job. But then these days, the traders who the researchers who join our program, make them go through the entire quant industry program, and then that helps them start their job with a much more better foothold of the domain than what we did a decade back.
As we have been able to understand, finance plays an important role in this job. What are the financial concepts that one has to know as a quant trader?
That's a nice question once again, but the answer would actually depend on the asset class that you're trading. There are some basic concepts that you would definitely need to understand very well, things like interest rate, time value of money, and so on. But then apart from that, probably things like supply demand and so on. But then apart from that, mostly everything is very asset class specific. So if you're trading options, for example, you would need to understand the different option price. And then once again, within options, it would again depend upon how you're trading options. If you're trading options in a very low frequency way, so basically you make one viewpoint and then make a trade and hold on to that trade for a long time, then you would want to price your options very accurately, in which case you would probably go for the Heston model of pricing options, or for example the CEV or the Durman-Kani method. But then if, for example, you are a high frequency option trader, you don't care about what is the truest fair price of the option, you just want to price it as quickly and then price it faster than everyone else with a fair bit of approximation. In which case, probably you would be okay with using the Black-Scholes model, or probably you could use some approximation formulas like the Brenner-Subramanian methodology or so on. So this is just with regards to trading options. Now, if you move to other asset classes, like say equities, when you're trading equities, you'd want to understand how dividends happen, how to forecast dividend, how to price stock lending and borrowing cost. Likewise, each asset class has its own peculiarities. If you're trading Forex, you would need to be good at understanding interest rate behaviors. If you're trading commodities, you would need to understand what causes certain commodities to go into backwardation and certain commodities to go into contango. So holding costs and so on. So therefore, the answer would be, it depends on which asset class you want to trade. And yeah, so that is it.
People often wonder why coding is so important for this role. What are your thoughts on this?
It is actually very important. I'll tell you why. There are two ways in which coding is relevant even for a quant trader. It starts, the first part is when you have to validate a hypothesis, and then the second part is when the hypothesis is validated. Now let's look at the first part, when you have to validate a hypothesis. How do you do that? You actually run statistical tests against huge amount of historical data. To be even able to do that, you need to write programs to be able to run your statistical tests against various historical scenarios and so on. So that is where coding skills comes in handy. Number two is, once you have made a hypothesis, you have done the statistical test, and then the results are encouraging, you will have to take it live. So the way to take it live is you can trade it manually, or you can trade it on as many financial instruments. You can try to scale it up. How do you scale it up? You can scale it up by trading it algorithmically. You can trade on as many instruments, as many for as long as you want, and then not miss even a single opportunity. So the execution part is the second area where you coding is required. Not just that, even I should have said there are three parts to it. The third part, which is the post-trade analytics. After you have traded, you would want to analyze your trades analyze your trades. Now, how do you analyze your trades? You need to figure out how many of your trades were good trades, what was happening at the in the market at the point of your trades, what is the behavior of the market at the crucial juncture. So to be able to figure all of them out, to be able to analyze your trades against the market in general, you would actually need to do a fair bit of programming. So programming is required first to validate your hypothesis, to convert your hypothesis into execution, and number three, to optimize your execution, which is doing post-trade analytics. So across the value chain, you would require coding to be able to excel.
If you had to hire someone, what are the qualities would you look for in a candidate?
Apart from the qualities that I had already mentioned, so for example, I had mentioned how people need to be good at statistics, things like time series analysis, and then how people also need to be good in technology. Being able to, in technology, I would say that a good grasp of Python to be able to run all those statistical tools. Knowledge and understanding of C, C++ might be good in our firm because our trading platform is written in C++. So in addition to that, I would also say that being street smart and then being smart in general, critical trait, because you would be competing against thousands of people on the exchanges who would be trying to make the same profitable trade. Being genial and then being a team player, because this domain involves a lot of analysis of trade data, the data which goes into hundreds of GBs per day. And so being able to work in a team is critical. So in terms of hard skills, statistics, coding, which is Python, and C++ is a boon. Subject matter knowledge, if you are trading, if you are being recruited for the options desk, then option pricing and so on. So subject matter, so technical skills, subject matter skills, and then the third one is the soft skills, which is basically how good are you in, how quick are you in solving puzzles, how good are you as a team player, and so on and so forth.